Thank you, Kay. I was motivated at a very young age to be an artist. I remember in first grade when the teacher walked around the room, we all had big pieces of paper on our desks. She walked up and down the aisles and she had a giant bowl in her hand and a big scoop. And she scooped out this big glob of blue jelly-like stuff right in the middle of that paper. I was in heaven. This was my first experience with finger painting. I couldn't believe how much fun this was. I was like, this is so cool. I know what I'm gonna be when I grow up. I'm gonna become a teacher so I can teach this all day long, every day. Because you know, you have to realize that when I was in grade school, way back in the 60s, you know, girls only could be three things when they grew up. Well, actually I should say four. They could be a housewife, they could be a secretary, they could be a nurse, not a doctor, of course, only nurses, or they could be a teacher. And so I thought, yeah, teaching, that'd be great. Teach art and I would be happy. As I progressed through school, I found out that teaching probably wasn't gonna be my thing, but I continued to love art. And I worked towards that goal throughout my entire education. Every opportunity I had to take an art class, I grabbed it. And I think my parents even realized that need because they actually hired private instructors to teach me, and my brother, who was very artistic as well. After graduating, I went to college. I got an art degree. I thought, yeah, this is what I'm going to do. But then I realized artists starve. Artists don't make money. Do you know any artists who make a living on their art? I've heard that there's about 2% of professional artists that actually do support themselves entirely on their art. And I realized in college that if I wanted to do art as a living or really be involved in art, I would probably have to teach it. I'd have to become a college professor and teach art or get a high school teaching job teaching art or something like that. That was the only way I was gonna be involved in it. And I struggled with that and decided, okay, I'll get a degree in communications as well because hey, I can do communication stuff that's creative, like sell advertising, create advertising, I don't know, maybe talk on TV, do stuff, I don't know. I just thought, hey, communications and art goes pretty well together. I'll try it. I did not think in terms of really making a living on my art until after I got married and discovered that my husband did not have motivation to make a lot of money. He was a great guy. He is a great guy, but he's retired now. But, you know, he loved to teach and he was really good at it. He taught lower elementary. But guess what? We actually started out as missionaries teaching on the Navajo reservation. And then he took jobs in private Christian schools, which everyone knows don't pay much. And he didn't want to teach in public school. So we never really made more than $20,000 a year. Literally. And I was finding that was kind of difficult. I didn't like it. So I started my business. I started my art business called AK Donahue Design. And I started going, I walked around, I talked to people. I said, hey, hire me. Hey, let me paint this for you and let's show it off to the public and then maybe I can get more work. I literally worked for free in order to get people to see what I was doing. And I painted murals, I painted decorative painting, I did all kinds of stuff like that. And I built that business up. Within 5 years, I was making six figures. And it's because I had that drive. You know what motivates me? Money. Yes, money. Do you know how much fun it is to paint a mural when you're making thousands of dollars? It is so much fun. I just love to be able to be up on that ladder, that scaffold, designing, talking to people about it, explaining my ideas, coming up with new concepts, and actually physically painting the wall or doing some other artwork. I've done lots of big paintings, small paintings, all kinds of stuff, but I love to paint. And I just have had so much more fun when you love what you're doing and you're actually getting paid to do it. That's the simple solution. That's what motivates me. And I found that by doing that, I learned so much along the way because this was the school of hard knocks. I mean, nobody showed me how to do this business. I just figured it out as I went. And so now after 30 years of creating that business. I've now stepped into the next realm, and that is to teach other people about what it is to be a paid artist, how to do it. So I started a nonprofit company called artistentrepreneurs.org. And this company has a little tagline, how to make a living as an artist. And that's what I do today. I am teaching a webinar series right now as we speak. It's going on. I'm going to be teaching the seventh session tomorrow at noon. I can't wait. It's so much fun to teach artists all the knowledge that I have, that I've gained over those years. And so I guess I am a teacher. I'm back to square one, but I'm really enjoying it because I have so much knowledge, all that stuff stuck up in my head, and I need to share it. I need to get it out there. I need to tell other artists, you can do it. You can make a living as an artist too. And I am so excited that I'm able to do that. And I will be sharing more information with you coming up in the future. So if you're interested, or if you know an artist that has some passion, have them check out artistentrepreneurs.org.